on pay-per-view.
And Scott, speaking of Halloween havoc, listen up, WCW fans in Las Vegas, Nevada, because tickets are still available, but going fast for Halloween Havoc at the MGM Grand Garden box office and all Ticketmaster outlets.
Speaking of Halloween Havoc also, I'm being told that following this contest, Mean Gene Orgeland will have an exclusive Saturday night interview with the man that will challenge for the World Heavyweight Championship at Halloween Havoc. Gene will talk to Diamond Dallas Page.
And Scott, this past Monday on Nitro, DDP joined us out at the announcer's set for the World's Heavyweight title match between Goldberg and Sting. And in the course of our conversation, I could almost see it in his eyes. Those hours of endless videotape study on the part of Diamond Dallas Page. He believes that they're going to pay off in Halloween Havoc because I think DDP has spotted a flaw in Goldberg.
Well, if there is one man in this great sport that can spot a flaw in Goldberg via videotape, it would be Diamond Dallas Page, one of the hardest working men I've ever met in professional wrestling.
Interesting backdrop to this matchup involving Norman Smiley, the Magic Man, and the gentleman Chris Adams. Of course, both men are from England, both former tag team partners, and as a matter of fact, they actually teamed up on a Starrcade event almost 8 years ago, Starrcade 1990, the Pat O'Connor Memorial Tag Team Tournament. Chris Adams and Norman Smiley formed a tag team. You know who they wrestled that night?
I do.
Who was it?
Rey Mysterio and Conan. Not Rey Mysterio Jr.
That's right.
But his uncle, not his father, but right, his uncle, Rey Mysterio.
Is that amazing as you look at the course of history from 1990 to 1998 that at Starrcade it was a tag team of Conan and Rey Mysterio Sr. You're right, the uncle of Rey Jr. against these two men. A little history lesson here on Saturday night.
Belly to back suplex by the gentleman Chris Adams on Norman Smiley. We've seen Norman Smiley have his problems with the cat, Ernest Miller. And speaking of the cat, last week here on Saturday night, Chris Adams came up short to the cat.
And we've seen a lot of people come up short lately to the cat. Once he has really focused himself on his, well, maybe his karate background and not trying to be a professional wrestler. He's the first to admit that he's not a pro wrestler.
He's also the first to admit he's the greatest. Boy, he won't shut up about that.
Yeah, just ask him. And the real deal and anything else that he can think about to promote himself. What a self-promoter this guy has turned out to be. But if you think about it, ever since then, he's been on quite a winning streak.
He certainly has. When he developed this new attitude, the cat has turned it on. Roll up. Pinning combination by Chris Adams. Got the two count on Norman Smiley. Smiley escapes the snapmare attempt by Chris Adams.
Now, did you see that move right there? Now, that is a prime example of two former tag team partners. Very tentative. Both men appeared to be going for the same move, then both backed off because they know each other so well.
Chris Adams now having that head wrenched in the wrong direction. The neck won't bend too far that way. Chris Adams, oh, ho, ho. Clean break from the gentleman, as a gentleman would do.
That mutual respect between the two. Oh, Adams that time caught him with a quick kick to the midsection.
Gut wrench by Chris Adams sets him up into the pile driver. Whoa. Oh, vicious. That hurt. That connected.
But why did he go for the pin?
I don't know.
Just a natural movement to follow up that pile driver with a pin. This is a critical error by Adams.
Oh. Oh, he dropped.
That was just the opening that Smiley needed to roll out of the way.
I mean, knee first from the top rope. Chris Adams, that's got to hurt. And don't think Smiley won't take advantage of that. European uppercut, high backdrop, takes Chris Adams once again on his back.
We've detailed in the past Norman Smiley's background in submission wrestling. He follows up with a head, but that just stunned Adams.
Adams into the ropes. Oh, hang on. Once again into the gut wrench. Can he get him up? Into the powerbomb.
Excellent recovery by Adams. Able to come up with the power bomb. Smiley tries to roll out of the way, find the safety of the ropes.
Here we go.
He's going to set him up for the super kick.
I thought it was. Whoa!
Why didn't he go for the super kick? Instead, he went for another offensive move, and Smiley able to get out of the way. Adams does not connect again.
That's a couple of times Chris Adams looks like he's been ready to win this contest and just made the wrong decision.
Roll through. There's that knee submission hold. He's got the leg staked out, and Adams quickly taps out.
And Norman Smiley will win it.
The Magic Man, Norman Smiley, remains on a roll, while the gentleman, Chris Adams, remains in the midst of a losing streak.
Mean Gene Okerlund standing by backstage with Diamond Dallas Page. Take it away, Gene.